Stop it.
Stop it.
Flex Wheeler, Muscle Development. I'm here with Eugene Mission. Listen, bro.
Mission.
Mission.
Mission on a mission.
Like Mission Impossible.
That's right.
No, Mission Possible. Possible. Mission is very possible. So listen, you just did an incredible commercial. How many people was it there, and what reason do you think they actually picked you to be the star for that commercial? With Dish Network.
Actually, I have auditions like every month, but I'm too big for some commercials. And the casting was like 1 week. Every day, like at least 30, 40 people, bodybuilders. I met one guy, it was Jeff Lone, actually, once. And I didn't expect they're going to pick me up there, like, then. First, I got email, we like you. Could you come to make sure we can see you, like, in real life? Like, all right, I came there. I see some guys even from my gym, from Bay Francis. Then, like, I got another call. Come over. Director wants to see you. Then he like, oh, fine. Then 2 days later, they got me.
Listen, Eugene, you came here from Russia.
Yeah.
So when you got here, you had nothing whatsoever. Did you ever dream of being able to?
I was sleeping in Center Park West.
What?
I was sleeping in Center Park West on a bench.
Really? What year was this?
2003. I was doing Night of Champions, right?
Yeah.
And somebody of my friends gave me key for 1 week to stay before show. Then she came, she said, Eugene, you have to move out. I moved out and I found place in the Center Park West. With my back, then I started to meet people. They took me like for two months to stay with them. Then I find job, no English completely. I don't know if you know Dave Barton gym. He opened line of gym in New York City, Las Vegas actually. He took me to work with them. He's then like, okay, we should to exam you. I like, all right. I completely didn't understand what they're saying. It's like for me it was noise. What are they talking about? Because English and American English is different.
Yes.
A lot of slang. And every time I try to listen, and I have like 12, I spent in the gym 12 hours a day to listen what people talk about. And I come home, open dictionary. Uh-huh. This guy said this. And I was making up the sentence, what they're saying. Then later, I did exam, but I don't know what I was doing. I just like, okay. I was speaking Russian to guy. We're doing lateral raises like that. We're doing bench press. We're doing squat. And they're like, perfect.
Listen, when you were competing, no one believed in you. You actually had people telling you that you should give up.
Even laughing at
me. What do you have to say to those people now that you made it? Here you are doing national commercials. You're at the Mr. Olympia, the biggest show in the world. What do you have to say to those naysayers now?
No, actually, I'm glad they didn't believe me because it keeps me motivated to do more. Because I see people who, in US, they call them losers. In Russia, a lot of people like that also. They don't want to work, they don't want to do anything. And they, when they see somebody going up, because I'm from projects. Even I took my wife Lina to visit my family, she said, it's worse than projects.
Yeah.
How so bad. You can see wild dogs outside, they can eat your life. And what's happened? After 8 years, I'm here. And when I was competing in Russia doing even city show, people were laughing at me because, oh, he cannot do it, he cannot do anything. Then I won city, I won nationals, I won Europe. And actually, I never decided to be a professional bodybuilder. I thought to get another title, Mr. World, and done on that because my goal is to do movies in the future. And I had a couple like people.